Okay, so assalamualaikum and hi everyone. So let us continue with chapter 2.3 lagi, Hess's law. Tapi saya nak ajar dissolution process of ionic solid. Okay, so first you should understand lah, dissolution and solution adalah benda yang sama. Okay, so what is dissolution process? Dissolution is a process by which solid, liquid or gas form a solution in a solvent. Okay, so maksudnya let's say you have solvent dalam ni, in this beaker, and then kamu nak larutkan, tak kisahlah kamu nak larut apakan apa, if you nak larutkan solid dalam tu, so the process is called dissolution process. Okay, kita just tahu when we add solid to solvent, if the solid is soluble in the solvent, then the solid will dissolve in solvent tu lah. Okay, tapi how exactly the reaction occur inside the solution kita tak nampak. Okay, tapi kita tahu, kita sepatutnya tahulah apa yang terjadi. Okay, so itu yang saya nak explain dekat sini, how the dissolution process occur. Okay, so macam mana dissolution process ni terjadi. Alright, so first let us start with this one. Water molecule are polar molecule. Yes, this one we already know since SEM 1. Okay, sebab water molecule the shape is V shape. Okay, look like this with two lone pair here. Okay, and then dia polar sebab the bonding between O dan H ni dia polar bond. Okay, so O is more electronegative toward, and so arrow kita semua pointing towards oxygen. Okay, alright. So area oxygen ni, if we want to label, dia slightly negative, while area for hydrogen is slightly positive. Okay, and then most ionic crystal are soluble in water. Yes, that's right. For example, NaCl, garam kan? NaCl is soluble in water. Okay, so now in this example, I'm going to use NaCl lah sebagai example saya. Okay, so tadi saya cakap NaCl, garam tu dia akan soluble in water. Tapi macam mana, apa reaction yang berlaku di dalam tu? First, kita tengok when solid ionic crystal, for example NaCl, is dissolved in water, their ions can be separated from each other and converted to gaseous ion. So, what happen actually adalah, first kamu bayangkan kamu ada ni NaCl, okay, solid ionic compound, and then kamu masukkan ke dalam solvent, and your solvent adalah water. Okay, so when you add NaCl to water, NaCl tu dissolve lah. Tapi what actually happen adalah this NaCl solid will dissociate dulu. Okay, dia akan dissociate to form Na plus gas and Cl minus gas. So itu yang dia cakap ni, ion separated from each other to form gases ion. Okay, so the equation should look like this lah, NaCl solid. Okay, so dissociate to form Na plus gas plus with Cl minus gas. Okay, so this equation kalau kita tengok balik, oh, equation ni sebenarnya adalah equation lattice dissociation energy. Okay, so over here delta H lattice dissociation is involved here. Okay, so lattice dissociation berlaku di sini lah. Okay, tapi macam before this lah, lattice dissociation and lattice energy sahaja, dia ada, dia lebih kurang, cuma dia terbalik je kan. Okay, so jangan pening. So kiranya bayangkan solid tu bila masuk dalam solvent, solid tu akan, ion dia tu akan pecah lah, separated from each other, jadi macam ni. Okay, alright, and then the electrostatic force between the gaseous ion, okay, and the polar water molecule causes the ion to be surrounded by water molecule. Okay, so this gaseous ion here, they refer kepada ion Na plus gas and Cl minus gas. Okay, alright, so ada electrostatic force. Electrostatic force here means attraction between gaseous ion dengan water molecule tu akan adalah attraction. So itu menyebabkan ion tu, which is Na plus dengan Cl minus tu, is surrounded by water molecule. Okay, so nak nampak this explanation dengan lebih jelas, kita akan tengok this diagram bawah ni. Okay, when an ionic compound dissolve in water, the negative end of the water molecule will attract the positive ion. Okay, so solid NaCl tadi dissociate to form Na plus gas dan Cl minus gas. Okay, so Na plus gas tu kan tadi sini dia cakap akan ada attraction dengan water molecule. Okay, dan menyebabkan water molecule tu akan surround this gases ion lah. Okay. Alright, tapi attraction tu berlaku dekat mana? Okay, so Na ni, since the charge is positive, dia akan attract dengan kawasan negative end of the water molecule. Okay, macam tadi saya cakap, water molecule, the shape is like this. Okay, so oxygen is slightly negative, while hydrogen is slightly positive. So, since oxygen is slightly negative, that's why from this diagram, you can see that oxygen yang pointed towards Na+. Okay, sebab oksigen ni negatif, Na plus positif. So, negatif-positif akan berlaku attraction. Okay. Alright. And then, this is for Na plus ion. How about Cl minus ion? Okay. So, Cl minus ion, since the ion is negative, dia akan attracted dengan water juga. Tapi, dia akan attracted with the positive part of this water molecule. Okay. The positive part adalah dekat hydrogen. So, that's why kalau kamu tengok all this molecule water ni, okay, yang dekat dengan Cl adalah yang H ni. So, maksudnya ada attraction antara positive part of this water molecule dengan negative ion, which is Cl minus. Okay. So, kiranya tadi solid tu masuk dalam air, solid tu akan dissociate to form gaseous ion. Gaseous ion tu akan dikelilingi oleh water molecule. So, ada attraction. So, itu menyebabkan gaseous ion tadi akan jadi aqueous. Okay. So, the formation of the bond, which is the electrostatic force between ion and water molecule, will release energy, and the energy is called hydration energy. Okay. So, kiranya ada dua proses lah sini. Dia ada lattice dissociation energy dengan lagi satu adalah hydration energy. So, kiranya if we want to summarize the dissolution process, okay, dissolution process involve two step. The first step adalah the solid will dissociate first. So, involve lattice dissociation energy. Okay, for example, Mx solid will dissociate to form M plus ion gas. Okay, and X minus ion gas. Okay, alright. So, energy is absorbed here. But lattice dissociation energy, dia adalah energy absorbed. That mean we need energy to break the bond. Okay. Alright. And then this ion, what happen next adalah is surrounded by water molecule tadi kan. So, bila dia surrounded with water molecule, then ada attraction antara this ion dengan water molecule. So, itu akan menyebabkan dia release energy, dan energy yang dia release tu adalah hydration energy. Okay. So, that's why dekat sini this ion in the form of gas akan tukar jadi ion lagi, tapi in the form of aqueous. Okay. Alright. So, kiranya daripada solid dah jadi ion aqueous. So, maksudnya solid tu soluble lah. Okay. Ataupun dah dissolve lah dalam solvent. Okay. So, for this one, energy release. Okay. So, next time, kalau saya tanya kamu, apa jadi kalau kita dissolve salt ataupun kita dissolve ionic compound dalam solvent, so kamu boleh baik, hopefully kamu boleh bayangkan lah proses-proses tadi. Okay, and then kenapa kita nak tahu ni? Sebab we need to create energy cycle for dissolution process. Okay, tapi energy cycle for dissolution process akan involve tiga jenis enthalpy lah. Enthalpy of solution, okay, ataupun we call it as enthalpy of dissolution. Kiranya proses solution tu macam mana, and then kita tahu solution tu nak berlaku, dia ada dua step. The first step adalah kena dissociate dulu, okay, dia punya ion, and then berlaku hydration, lepas tu baru dia jadi solution. Okay, so in this one kita start dengan enthalpy of solution lah. Okay, usually I will start with enthalpy of solution. If you refer back to your notes, okay, list of enthalpy tu, okay, equation kalau from solid pergi jadi ion tapi dalam phase aqueous, itu adalah enthalpy of solution. Okay, but for enthalpy of solution to occur, this solid must dissociate to form ion gas first. Okay, that is what we call enthalpy of lattice dissociation. And then, this ion is surrounded by water molecule. Lepas tu, dia jadi ion aqueous. Okay, ini adalah enthalpy of hydration. Okay, so kalau soalan keluar, dia suruh minta kamu buat tulis energy cycle for dissolution process. Kadang-kadang dia tak bagi tahu dissolution process involve benda-benda ni, sebab dia assume memang kamu tahu. Okay, dissolution process tu. So kena boleh tulis energy cycle for this. Okay, and then ada one example, okay, yang saya buat untuk dissolution process. Okay, so based on the data given below, enthalpy height ni hydration, hydration Na plus is negative 390 kilojoule per mole. Enthalpy of hydration Cl minus negative 380 kilojoule per mole. Enthalpy of solution NaCl is positive 6 kilojoule per mole. Dia kata construct the energy cycle diagram to represent the dissolution or solution of NaCl. So as you can see from this question, dia tak ada bagi tahu enthalpy apa, nak tulis apa, dari mana ke mana kan. So you should know. Okay, so kita akan start macam tadi. We should start from enthalpy of solution. Actually, you can start from anywhere lah. Tapi, my habit is start from solution. NaCl, solid, pergi jadi Na plus aqueous plus with Cl minus aqueous. Okay, so ini adalah enthalpy of solution. Okay, and dia dah bagi ya. Enthalpy solution over here is 6 kilojoule per mole. Okay, and then next one, kita tahu dalam solution ataupun dissolution process involve lattice dissociation energy. So that's mean this NaCl solid will break down ataupun will dissociate to form Na plus gas plus with Cl minus gas. Okay, so enthalpy here adalah delta H lattice dissociation energy. Okay, alright, and then next one adalah hydration lah from this Na. Okay, Na plus gas pergi jadi Na plus aqueous, Cl minus gas pergi jadi Cl minus aqueous. So delta H dia lain-lain lah. Delta H hydration for Na plus adalah negative 390 kilojoule per mole, while enthalpy hydration for Cl minus is negative 380 kilojoule per mole. Okay, so kita dah siap dah energy cycle diagram. So settle for the first question. Second one, dia kata calculate the lattice energy of NaCl. Dia minta lattice. Okay, so if we look at our energy cycle, kita macam terfikir mana ada lattice kan. Kita ada lattice dissociation energy, adalah. Okay, tapi lattice energy tak ada. Okay, so kena tahu lattice dissociation energy dengan lattice energy dua benda berbeza. Lattice dissociation from solid to ion. Okay, tapi kalau lattice energy from ion to solid. So dia ada dua cara lah. Sama ada kamu kira ni, and then kamu tukar nilai dia jadi negatif jadi positif, positif jadi negatif, dan yang bersesuaian lah. Ataupun saya rasa the easiest way adalah kita ubah terus arrow ni. Okay, so now saya ubah arrow. Instead of arrow pointing downward, saya akan ubah arrow tu ke atas. Okay, so that bila arrow ni ke atas, maksudnya adalah ion combine to form solid. Okay, so bila dia combine to form solid, ini adalah enthalpy lattice. Exactly the same macam apa yang dia nak. Okay, so that senang calculation kita. Okay, and then number 2. Okay, so lattice energy nak calculate macam mana? Okay, how to calculate? Sama macam energy cycle before this. Kita tengok arrow dia. Okay, so this arrow ke sini. Okay, ini ke sini. Okay, so maksudnya arrow ini tambah dengan inilah. So, dua ni tambah. Okay, and then we produce dua benda ni. Okay, alright. So, maksudnya sekarang kita tambah delta H lattice plus with delta H not solution equal to, okay, so equal to dua benda ni. So, delta H hydration. Okay, ada not juga. Plus with delta H not hydration for Cl minus. Okay, so dah ada nilai, then substitute lah. Okay, delta H lattice is the one that we want to find. Delta H solution given is this one, 6. So, 6 kilojoule per mole. Okay, and then delta H hydration Na plus is negative 390 kilojoule per mole. Enthalpy hydration of Cl minus negative 380 kilojoule per mole. Okay, and then carilah delta H lattice kita. So my answer enthalpy lattice adalah negative 776 kilojoule per mole. Okay, so betul lah sebab enthalpy lattice memang negatif pun sebab lattice ni adalah kita nak form something. Okay, daripada ion kita nak form solid. So in order to form something kita release energy. Okay, tapi kalau dari solid pergi ke ion itu nak break something kita perlu energy. Okay, so your delta H lattice should be negative. Okay, so I think that's all for this solution process. Thank you.